Hello my loves, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome, welcome. My name is Leizel and today I'm going to be showing you guys what my favorite products have been for the past month of May. So I actually did not do an April favorites video. I don't know if you guys would have noticed, but yeah, I didn't do one because I haven't really been trying anything new lately. I honestly have not been wearing makeup as regularly. Like, wow, who am I? I've just been taking a really long break from everything and I'm only just now starting to ease myself back into my normal routine, but I still have some pretty good things to show you guys. So if you do enjoy this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any other videos I post. And yeah, let's get into the favorites. Alrighty, so the first thing that I have to show you guys is kind of like an oldie but a goodie reformulated, if that makes sense. Those of you who watch my channel regularly would know how much I rave on about this product. This is the Astralis Ready Set Go Finishing Powder. It is honestly my favorite powder for setting my under eyes. Like, nothing beats this stuff. However, Astralis recently came out with this bad boy, which is pretty much like an upgrade from this. So obviously this is like a loose translucent powder. This is a pressed translucent powder, which makes everything so much easier when it comes to setting the under eye. However, I do feel like, I don't know if they've changed the formula a little bit. It does the same thing. It keeps my concealer in place and sets all day. I don't experience any creasing. I've raved on about this powder a lot. What I love about it most is that I honestly swear to God, I get no creasing whatsoever when I use this stuff. Like, the only negative thing I would have to say about it is that when I applied it to my concealer, if I went a shade or two lighter, it would kind of bring it back down a notch and kind of darken it a little bit, which is not what I wanted to do. You know, I wanted to brighten my under eyes. However, this wouldn't let me do that. But I couldn't stop using it because it honestly sets my concealer in place so well and it won't budge throughout the day. However, this stuff pretty much does the exact same thing, but it's really brightening. And I don't know if Astralis changed the formula or if they added something to it or what, but sometimes I go a little bit ham with this and it can really, really brighten up the under eye. But I just love this stuff. It's so, there it is right there. It's really, really smooth and just feels so nice when you apply it. And yeah, I'm just really thankful that Astralis finally came out with a pressed version. I always wondered if they ever would do that, like come out with a pressed version. And they answered my prayers. So I've really been liking this lately, and since I got this, I have not touched this. So that's saying something. I have another product by Astralis to show you guys. This is their new Midas Touch Serum Primer. And pretty much it is exactly what the name says. It's a primer in serum form that comes in this glass bottle with a dropper. Let me just put some on the back of my hand. So I'll give you one drop. You guys probably can't tell, but it has like gold glitter in it. I don't know if they're legitimate gold flakes because this thing only cost 20 bucks. So I don't know if it is legitimate, but the reason why I picked this up is because as soon as I saw it, it totally reminded me of the Guerlain primer, which as most of you would know is very, very expensive. So I have been testing this out for the past few weeks to see whether or not it could be potentially a dupe for it. So there it is on the back of my hand. It just honestly, it feels so beautiful to apply and it smells so nice. In all honesty, it smells very similar, and I totally feel like if you are looking for a cheaper alternative to this, this could definitely be a dupe. I don't know 100% whether it does the exact same thing. I'm still kind of testing it out and gauging that, but I have been trying it out for the past few weeks and I have been loving it. What I love about this as well is that it has vitamin E within it, which if you guys know me, then you know I love vitamin E. Why do I always rhyme? I swear to God, guys, I always rhyme in my videos and I don't do it on purpose. It just happens. So this has vitamin E in it, which I love because that is very soothing to my skin. And if you haven't seen my skincare routine video, then you may not know that I am a big advocate for vitamin E when it comes to helping your scars fade. So as soon as I see anything with vitamin E in it, I wanna snatch it up right quick. In all honesty, I do feel like it has helped to keep my skin hydrated throughout the day, especially now that we are going into the cooler months. For those of you guys who live overseas, yes, down here in the Southern Hemisphere where Australia is, we are going into winter. So I'm definitely all for hydrating products at the moment. So yeah, I've really been liking this primer and I definitely do see this potentially becoming a dupe for this. So if you are looking for something that is a little more affordable, because this bad boy costs a pretty penny, then check out the Astralis Primer. Next up, we have the Benefit Hello Flawless Pressed Powder. I don't know why it took me so long to pick this up, but I actually had a friend who asked me whether I had tried it out, and I was like, no, I haven't. And she told me that it was really good. So I went to my local Benefit counter and picked up this bad boy. If you guys are wondering what shade I am Petal. This powder definitely packs a punch. I feel like it is very full coverage. If you wanted to, you could even build it up and wear it on its own. However, I just like to dust a little light coating over my foundation to set it in place when I want to be extra covered. So yeah, I just had to throw this into my favorites because it's pretty much the only powder that I've been reaching for this month when it comes to setting my liquid foundations in place. And yeah, I've really been liking it. Next up, I have a foundation to show you guys, and I'm pretty sure a lot of you will be able to guess which one I've been loving the most lately. So here it is right here. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. I did a first impressions on this, and right from the get-go, I was obsessed. Unfortunately, Wet n Wild Cosmetics is not available here in Australia, and I just don't understand why. Their products are so affordable. This foundation alone cost $6, and I'm pretty sure there's no foundation in our drugstores over here that costs that much. Like, that's so inexpensive for a foundation. I just can't get over the price. Super inexpensive, but honestly has better quality than some of my higher end foundations, which is very shocking to me because I don't know how they were able to create such an amazing foundation for such a low cost. This is honestly everything I look for in a foundation. It's super full coverage, very lightweight on the skin, and the color. If you guys are wondering, the color that I am matched to at the moment is golden beige. The color is spot on. Like, the foundation that I'm wearing today is not exactly my color, which I'm mad about, but it's okay. And I kind of wished I had used this instead, but that's all right. But yeah, I've just honestly been obsessed with this lately. And if you are thinking about trying it, definitely try it, because I feel like this is like the number one foundation for me at the moment. This is probably, yeah, I'm gonna say it, this is my favorite foundation that I've ever worn. Just saying. I have another Wet n Wild product to show you guys, and I'm actually wearing it today. So here it is right here, the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighter in Precious Petals. Oh my goodness, guys. I just dropped it. Alrighty, so here it is in the pan. It's so beautiful. I can't get over how pretty this is. This highlighter, I'm pretty sure it's only $5. Correct me if I'm wrong. Not 100% sure, because yet again, we don't have Wet n Wild here in Australia. So I'm kind of just going off the top of my head. I don't know exactly how much it costs, but I know that it was super inexpensive. Let me just give you guys a quick little swatch. It's so pretty. It is honestly so pretty. Oh, like, check out that shine. Yes, girl, give it to me. I'm honestly obsessed with this, and whenever I do my makeup, I reach for this because it's such a beautiful highlighter. Like, just, I have no words. Wet n Wild is doing the damn thing. Since we are now officially in winter here in Australia, I've been all about skincare, and I think that's why I haven't been wearing as much makeup lately, because I've really been focusing on my skin. I go through these phases where I like, I'm obsessed with makeup, and then I'm obsessed with skincare, and vice versa. Lately, I've been all about my skin. So I have been loving the Glam Glow Gravity Mud Firming Mask. If you guys saw my high-end luxury haul from cosmedy.com, you would have seen this bad boy featured in that. I actually have to say, yes, I was gifted this. I did not purchase this with my own money, but that does not sway my opinion on this thing. This stuff is legit. I don't know, oh, girl, I just, what's not by accident. Definitely don't want to be wasting it, so I'm just going to quickly show you guys. That's how it looks in the pot. It's like a silvery white pearly color, but when you apply it on the skin and it dries up, you look like Tin Man. And I really like it. It's a fun mask to use, and I honestly, when I first tried it, I didn't think that it was anything special. I was like, okay, I'm gonna put this mask on and what's it gonna do? Like, it didn't feel like it was doing anything for my skin. But best believe, when I peeled it off, my skin looked so good. I kid you not, my skin, it looked like I had just had like Botox or something. I've never had Botox, just saying. But it looked like how I would imagine my skin to look like if I had ever had a Botox before. I don't know, it did something for me, guys. It did something for me. And I know this stuff is expensive, so I'm not saying that it's like a necessity to go out and get, because it is very expensive. But if you are looking to try a really cool mask, then this is it. I love the whole process of just applying it on and letting it sit, doing your thing, and then peeling it off. It's just so fun. So yeah, I've been really liking this mask lately. Alrighty guys, we are down to the last item, and this is actually not a makeup product. This is an accessory. So, bam. These are the High Keys by Desi Perkins and Key Australia. I'm obsessed with them. Like, she just did the damn thing when she designed these. I love these. I actually do have the gold ones. Yeah, the gold ones. And as soon as I saw that she was releasing these bad boys, I knew I had to get me a pair. And when I got them, CJ actually liked them so much that he had to cop himself a pair. So we are matching, and we have matching sunnies, all thanks to Desi Perkins. I love these. I'm pretty sure they are still in stock if you check the Key Australia website. I will leave a direct link below though. But yeah, I'm obsessed. And they come with this clear case, which is awesome, and like a little cleaning cloth inside. But yeah, I've been obsessed with these. I really like how they look, and I feel like you can wear them with so many different looks and just like walk on through and not give a damn. So those are my favorites for the past month. I want you guys to comment down below and let me know what you have been loving lately, because I'm always up to try new things. As always, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're still here and you're still watching and you aren't subscribed yet, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any other videos I post. As always, I'll leave a full list of everything I talked about in this video in the description box, where you can also find all of the links to my social media accounts. So Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and now Facebook, because I recently just made a Facebook page so that I could stay in touch with you guys. So yeah, check those out down below. So with that being said, I hope you guys are having a fabulous week, and I will catch you all in my next video. Stay glowing.